Once there were three trees on a hill in the woods. They were discussing their hopes and dreams when the first tree said, "Someday I hope to be a treasure chest. I could be filled with gold, silver, and precious stones. I could be decorated with intricate carvings, and everyone would see the beauty." Then the second tree said, "Someday I will be a mighty ship. I will take kings and queens across the water and sail to the corners of the world. Everyone will feel safe in me because of the strength of my hull." Finally, the third tree said, "I want to grow to be the tallest and strongest tree in the forest. People will see me on the top of the hill and look up to my branches and think of the heavens and gods and how close to them I'm reaching. I will be the greatest tree of all time, and people will always remember me." After a few years of praying that their dreams would come true, a group of woodsmen came upon the trees. When one came to the first tree, he said, "This looks like a strong tree. I think I should be able to sell the wood to a carpenter," and he began cutting it down. The tree was happy because he knew that the carpenter would make him into a treasure chest. At the second tree, a woodsman said, "This looks like a strong tree. I should be able to sell it to the shipyard." The second tree was happy because he knew he was on his way to becoming a mighty ship. When the woodsman came upon the third tree, the tree was frightened because he knew that if they cut him down, his dreams would not come true. One of the woodsmen said, "I don't need anything special for my tree, so I'll take this one," and he cut it down. When the first tree arrived at the carpenter's, he made it into a feed box for animals. He then placed it in a barn and filled it with hay. This was not at all what he had prayed for. The second tree was cut and made into a small fishing boat. His dreams of becoming a mighty ship and carrying kings had come to an end. The third tree was cut into large pieces and left alone in the dark. The years went by, and the trees forgot about their dreams. Then one day, a man and woman came to the barn. The woman gave birth, and they placed the baby in the hay-filled feed box that was made from the first tree. The man wished that he could have made a crib for the baby, but this manger would have to do. The tree could feel the importance of this event, and he knew that it held the greatest treasure of all time. Years later, a group of men got in the fishing boat made from the second tree. One of them was tired and went to sleep. While they were out on the water, a great storm arose, and the tree didn't think it was strong enough to keep the men safe. The man woke the sleeping man, and he stood and said peace, and the storm stopped, that it had carried the King of Kings in its boat. Finally, someone came and got the third tree. It was carried through the streets as the people mocked the man who was carrying it. When they came to a stop, the man was nailed to the tree and raised in the air to die at the top of a hill. When Sunday came, the tree came to realize that it was strong enough to stand at the top of the hill and be as close to God as was possible, because Jesus had been crucified on it. When things don't seem to be going your way, always know that God has a plan for you. If you place your trust in Him, He will give you great gifts, gifts even greater than what you asked for. Each of these trees got what they wanted, just not in the way they had imagined. We don't always know what God's plans are for us. We just know that His ways are not our ways, but His ways are always best. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe to see more from me.